lack an appreciation for history. Jedi were no joke. I'm sure you'll see.
Jedi.
Why did you activate the array?
It's been many years since I last took the life of a Jedi.
Why did you activate the...
I heard you. Long ago, Dagon bested me in combat. Earned my loyalty. We fought side by side until the Jedi betrayed him. Took many of your order to defeat me. And yet, they dishonored me. Denied me a warrior's death. And left me to rot in a cage for centuries. So, seems our destinies are intertwined. The demise of your order allowed me to escape.
And yet, nothing has changed. You're still just Dagon's servant.
Time does not diminish my loyalties. Without a code, you can only serve yourself.
Where's the compass, Ravis?
I owe you nothing, Jedi! If you want that knowledge from me, you're gonna have to fight for it.
Very well.
More than that! Enough!
yourself.
Where is the compass?
Centauri Kree's observatory. As Dagon suspected, I have opened the way. He goes there now.
I defeated you. Fight with me. We can take on Dagon together.
I will not, Jedi. After all these centuries, I still dream of Tantalor. I had hoped to see it again, but... Oh, that is not to be. Miss Dagon Gera stands in your way.
You don't have to do this.
Only one of you will reach Tantalor. Jedi, give me my warrior's death. No!
We should go. Bud. Freeze, you there?
Cal, I don't know what you did, but those vulture droids are making a hasty exit. Landing. I'm gonna bring the Mantis in now.
Copy that.
I'll be waiting for you, kid.
Abandoned the Jedi Code. Now look at him. Consumed by his obsession with Tantalor. How's that different from what we're doing? Don't worry about it. Thanks for having my back.
running from a blaster. Better run a little faster. Goodbye, lone saloon. The location, shattered moon. Hey, look at that. He ain't dead. How you doing, kid?
How?
Whatever you did up there sure kicked the firebug nest.
Ravis is gone.
Yeah, that'll do it.
So let me guess. Back to Kobo?
Yeah, I think so.
Say, Jetpack, give me a hand up here.
Yeah.
Don't tell Grease, but he's right about this moon. Creepy.
Not now. I need some time to think.
I don't trust a lucky streak. Not in this galaxy.
Something about this place I just don't like.
Just like you were scared of Dathomir?
Now, hold on. That's different. We knew that planet was full of nasties. But this moon, it's the unknown that spooks me, you know? All creaking and abandoned, it's too quiet.
You're just superstitious.
Oh yeah? You think so, huh? Well, I was right about the witch planet.
It wasn't so bad.
Wasn't so bad? There were zombies, Cal. Zombies.
What do you make of this moon?
I find it intriguing.
What's more intriguing? The abandoned science facility, the bizarre stellar anomaly, or the constant threat of attack?
Yes.
Yeah, I think I'm starting to get you.
What do you think we'll find? I need to clear my mind.
You're brooding. Again.
That easy to read my mind?
It's no Jedi trick. I just pay attention.
Shattered moon. I saw Dagon confront Centauri. He was so consumed by Tantalor that he completely lost his way. Reminds me of my fight with the Empire these last few years. Let's just say I don't want to end up like him.
You are very stubborn, but ambition does not drive you.
I just don't understand why she didn't see the change in him before it was too late.
They dreamed together and suffered together. Shared dream is not so easy to wake from. Is that what troubles you? Losing yourself?
Yeah. A little.
you ever stray from your path, we will guide you back. With Ravis dead, the Bedlam Raiders have been wounded. This makes them dangerous.
They weren't exactly harmless before.
No, they were not. I will look after the outpost. The Raiders may strike if they think we are vulnerable.
I'll be back as soon as I can.
I know you will, and I will be waiting. Don't you have a mountain to climb?
I gotta hand it to you, kid. Things are looking better than ever.
And you wanted to sit this one out.
Oh, well, count on you to prove me wrong, Cal. When we were all ready to fold, you never stopped fighting.
And we can't stop now.
Yeah, I know. We still got a lot of work ahead of us. But you gotta remember to stop and appreciate how far we've come. Don't you got stuff to do?
You, Raider Killer. Heard you cleared out that watchtower.
You heard right.
Not bad. I didn't think you could hack it. Let's just hope there aren't any consequences for the rest of us.
Let's stop.
Thank you. Come on, Echo. Easy, Neko. Let's go, BD. You got it!
That did the trick.
Let's grab a lift, BD.
This'll be easy.
Let's fight together.
Stop them!
Let's go.
Yeah!
Come on, buddy. Not the enemy.
Hold the line.
Neutralizing.
Protect me.
That's a stretch.
Just wait. Demoralizing, huh?
Thank you.
Okay, no funny business. Just put the scrap down and your hands up. This area is under the control of the Bedlam Raiders.
Pretty folk, ain't ya? This is a lot of pretty interesting tech you have here. Why, if I weren't holding you up, I'd probably be buying.
Wow! We are not here to engage in commerce.
Always keeping me on the straight and narrow, huh? There's a good droid. Best do as they say. Let's not make this any messier than it needs be. You're not supposed to be here.
Appreciate it.
Oh, no, baby.
I wonder how long this has been here. Raiders. They're trying to destroy the camp. Villages can live in one of these crawlers. Traveling across planets as a single unit. But this one doesn't look like it's moved in a while. Are you all okay? Not sure what that means, but you all look safe. If you need any supplies, you should stop by the Rambler's Reach outpost. Yeah. See you around. Jawas seem pleased, huh? Maybe they're happy they have somewhere to do business. Breeze is gonna love this. Can't see the Jawas anymore. Can't see them anymore. Wonder where we'll find them next. Okay, let's go. Creatures were killed by blaster bombs.
Don't give him any space. Big mistake.
I get it. They're weird things. I'd like to know what's in them, too. But we don't have that kind of time or resource. So, no. And please stop asking.
You should be prepared. I'm always prepared. Bring it on. I won't let anyone destroy me. Intruder!
What's that? Toss me a stim, bud. Maybe we should take up prospecting, huh, BD?
I know. Come on now. It'll be okay.
You okay?
The beast here gets spooked when something's wrong. Don't know what it is, but I've learned to trust him. You headed up the mountain?
Looks like it.
I don't know if that's mad or brave or both, but you watch yourselves up there, you hear?
You got it.
Prospector's Folly, we call it. Pretty treacherous. Crawling with all kinds of dangers.
Sounds like our kind of place. BD1.
My bantable mum dubbed me Scuba Stev. Scuba the Fisher, am I?
You know, there's a fish tank down in Pylon Saloon that could use some attention.
The Pylon Saloon? That labyrinth-infested watering hole down in your valley.
All right. Forget I asked.
Ah, fine, twist my arm. I'll do it. Meet me at the saloon and we'll appraise this so-called tank. Couldn't stay away. You're not even seeing the sea spray once it's misted your gums.
I guess not.
You're the aspect of a fisher, lad. And lucky for you, we're perched just above the lair of the sea fish.
Sea fish, huh?
That's right. An impossible catch. No fisher in the right mind would pursue such a quarrelsome foe. No fisher, but Scuba Stev.
Thanks.
I'm sorry.
Farewell. Oh, a newcomer. Who are you?
I'm Cal. This is BD1.
Are you here to rescue us?
We were just exploring. How long you been here?
We have been trapped out here for at least a standard cycle. Maybe more.
We?
Ah, yes. It is just me. And has been for some time. But you have cleared the way. Are the raiders gone then?
We took care of them. Maybe you should leave before more come.
Yes, I will return to the outpost at Rambler's Reach. We had a domicile there. I hope to see you again.
The smell down here is potent.
My son.
No lift platform here. Raiders have rigged this place. Come on, buddy. Stuff is everywhere. I don't like the look of it. We should be careful. BD-1. Nice job.
Scour this place for anything of note. If anyone tries to interfere, crush them.
to warn the others.
I don't think we're making it back.
Acid? Let's keep her distance. Hey, what's waiting beneath the surface this time?
These streams' climbs harbor a most mysterious resident, the Viscid Lurker. They love to nestle into the cozier reaches of the sea, but they're need too cozy for Scuba Steph.
Nice, I think.
The
Republic must have used this to reach the surface. Well, I don't think they fell through a hole in the roof every time, buddy.
Fascinating. I can't figure it out.
Perhaps there's something in the satellite laboratory that could help us analyze it. See that? Good job. Think we can use this elsewhere?
What was that? Oh no!
Gruesome. They've been here a long time. Thank you. here, BD. Do your magic, BD.
Where is he? Where is Dagon Gera?
I don't know. We couldn't find him. But he murdered Jedi. He must answer for his crimes.
I understand. You're following your code, and I am following mine. I owe him everything. But you, I owe nothing.
We're studying the growths here, as well as more research on Kobo matter. They really found this whole planet fascinating. Must have hated having to leave it all behind. Come on, let's go. Isn't it a little dark down there for fishing?
A true fisher doesn't rely on the sun to do the seeing. A true fisher fishes with the mind. Sink your eyes on this. You're asking yourself, how in the deep did old Scuba know where the fish he was hiding? But what you don't know is that the Barracoon fish always travels northward.
How does it always travel north?
Well, you see, north, it's a relative... Fine, I bumped into it on my way down. But a true fisher knows that a pocket full of luck is more important than some cod migration pattern. Now for a story, if you've the time. So, you wish to prick up your ears and receive the tale of Scuba?
If you're sharing stories, we'll listen.
Then you be a fool, my lad. A sordid tale will bring you nothing but grief and woe.
Okay, well, if you're not sharing stories, we'll...
Oh, fine, I'll tell you. At your own insistence, and at your own peril... The story begins in a small village on the frozen banks of Sakavi Tarn, my home world. Nights black as quillfish innards, winters so cold a stern look could turn you to glass.
Doesn't sound like the easiest place to grow up.
Difficult, aye. From the moment your mother's milk froze on your tongue to the moment you founded upon frozen streets. You see, the fishes, they had the right of it. They dwelt far below the ice, where warm currents danced like ribbons in the wind. To fish so scarce a quarry, on account of the great fish famine. Well, it's nearly a mild undertaking. But for all me bellyaching now, there's a peaceful enough life for a wee Sicarian with an instinct for the road.
So you discovered your talent early.
Such a talent was I, that as a lad, me hardly sporting my first prickly chin here, I was given an audience with Undun. But that be a tale for another time. Where were we? Ah, yes. By virtue of my prodigious fishing talents, I was taken to see the mysterious one they call Undun. I can see it still. Wee scuba, ushered into yon black-mouthed cave. I could barely make out a figure glinting with moonlight. I scrubbed my eyes like a old tar scrubbing the deck. And there she was, a vast creature. Great tentacles blooming from her blubber, like cables gorging on a fuel tank. One of the tentacles twitched into the air, just over my head, and then, wham! Right on the noggin, so I'm told. I staggered out the cave like a lover first acquainted with the deck. But something else happened. I think, when that fell tentacle struck me, Undun took something straight out to me brain and put something else in.
She put something in your brain?
Aye, boy. The subtle art of catching a fish. The art of focus. And in the dark, with nothing but the bristles on your chin for company, that focus is special. From that day forward, when I plunged my line into the frigid waters, it would emerge with a fish. 3 times out of 7.
That's less than half.
My manager told me that I'd be the one to save them from the great fish famine. Little did I know that the grapnel was soon to arrive on our shores.
Gonna assume that's a bad thing.
Perhaps, lad. And perhaps not. But that'd be a story for another time. The tale continues. When we last spoke, I warned of the grapnel's arrival. That great ship came descending on us like an anchor cutting the deep. Ne'er a more fearsome ship did you clap eye on. She was sharp, like a fish, like the nose of a bony fish. She had 3 great claws. Aye, the landing gear, but when her great jaws parted, aye, the loading ramp. Nah, will you hush and let Scuba tell the story? Her great jaws parted, disgorging her dread crew. A more vile pack of fisher folk you never did see. And led by the vilest of them all, Captain Wan Yik Wit, the bearded bizzle-less bat that he intended to fish in our waters. Trophy hunters they were, in search of the most rare catches. Well, we Sicavians refused. We had the great famine to contend with, see? Every fish was precious. But the ferocious captain didn't care for our troubles. With a belch, he produced from his creel a mighty harpoon. Wait, cried wee Scuba, hopping off of his rock. I know these waters like the taste of my own tongue. There'll be few fish beneath yon ice. But, continued I, if you take me with you, and if you leave my village be, I could show you how to coax the rarest of fishes onto your line. Aye. The dread captain stroked his briny beard. After a long moment, he held out his hand and grinned most terribly. Lad, said he, you be in luck. I'll be requiring another from a crew. One who knows the curve of the sea. Oh, Cal. If I could only go back to that moment when I shook Captain Wet's rigid hand. If only I'd never stepped off my wee rock. But my encounter with Undun had given me a taste for the unknown. I couldn't resist the call of adventure, and I had to save my people. So, I left with the grapnel, thinking the business done. I would be a fisher for Captain Wet. Of course, my adventure had only begun. For just when the grapnel hit orbit...
More trouble, I take it?
Ah, but I've havered on long enough. And come back another time and I'll tell you more.
It's locked. Let's stop here. What do you think? Change your style? Thank you. about something like this? Think this could work? Ready to go. We already checked out the caverns. You were right. They're not safe at all.
I know that. Why does nobody take notice of me? I'm speaking truth.
Well, at least you came out in one piece.
With the Raiders, I don't want trouble.
Easy. We're not. We're not Empire either.
What do you want then?
We're headed up the mountain. What do you know about it?
You must be crazy to go up there, but I don't know much. The folly was already deadly to most folk even before the Empire set up shop. You should turn back.
What is this place?
Old Loden Dock, back from when things were busy around here. Don't get much activity anymore, though. Not since...
Since what?
No, it's nothing. Never mind.
Feels like there's something about this place we should know.
Mountain's not safe, stranger. I just watch where you go snooping around.
We're not really the careful type. What is it, buddy? All right, let's go. Fall behind. We'll get around faster now.
Jump!
Better catch up. You never have enough of these. Easy, Neko.
Jump!
Huh?
Come on, buddy. Nice job. See what's up ahead, buddy. Okay, let's go. Passing through, officer.
Nothing that ain't made of Durasteel is passing through this electron wall.
Weapons hot, sir. Let's shoot him before he gets ideas.
Negative. We've got our orders.
Sure you can't make an exception?
You smell that, scum? That's imperial air you're breathing. So get back before I forget my orders and we see how tough you really are.
Why don't you drop the shield and we'll find out?
Nice try, Vermin. Lucky for you, this gate's got a remote switch.
You will lower the shield. I already showed you my authorization.
You already showed me your authorization?
Sir?
TK-783 to base command. Lower the shield.
What?
Wait.
Easy.
Think of the reward, Shanna. Come on.
Okay.
More priorite. Wonder what this will fetch a dumb shop.
Escape.
are you fishing for?
I'm hunting the ferocious me. Did you know the me was the very first fish we scuba caught?
That must have been quite a day.
Aye, I was barely yee-high back then. Little scuba swam headlong into the creature's mouth. But, plucky as I was, it couldn't digest me before fishing fellows pulled us out.
Sounds more like it caught you.
Aye, it takes me back. Stick around, boy, and I'll top us off with a tale. So, you wish to hear of a time on the Grapnel with the crew of the dread Captain Wanyak Wet?
Let's hear it.
Aye. My tenure began with quite a bump. The moment the Grapnel hit orbit, her klaxons began to sing. A barrack ship full of lawful types swam out to the stars and hailed us. What be the meaning of this? Growled our captain. Where's the boat fisher folk? Your transponder codes tell a different tale, came the reply. You be standing on stolen property, you do. Aye, you've rightful caught us, said the captain. Come on aboard, and I'll surrender what was stolen. But scarcely had the lubbers set foot on the deck of the Grapnel, when wham! The captain's harpoon skewered them like a quailfish on a spit. Now you can't do that when you're running like, can you? Said the captain to me, grinning in his foulsome way. I'm sorry to say that I picked up the harpoon that black day. For years, I did not toss a fish back into the sea when I caught her. Well, that is until... blubbered you to death. I'll continue my tale soon, lad.
Tolo recommended we check this chamber out.
Welcome, Jedi. Our problems are often matters of perspective. By shifting our position, so too moves our thinking, and thus by reframing it, a problem may not seem so vexing after all.
Sounds familiar.
I never thought I would find this planet so energizing.
There is something unique about it, no?
I must show you a spring I found recently. The aura there is invigorating.
Dagon boarded the first transport out.
Nonsense. He would never.
Wherever he is, we need him. This is not good.
sure Z can decrypt this for us. Thank you.
sector... Wait, what's that? Looks like it's from the clone... It's incoming!
Nest of Shiverpedes. Grease is gonna love this story. Let's take a look. This is a good find. Imperials. Just gotta keep climbing. Thank you.
More priorite. Wonder what this will fetch a dumb shop. We can trade this at Doma's shop. Raiders have the Empire spooked. This could get pretty ugly, BD. Visibility's pretty bad. Gotta push through. Energy conduit. You don't have anything for it, do you? Is that an Imperial shuttle? I don't know why they were flying in such poor conditions. Want to check it out? The Force is with me.